compassionate God, the idealized Lord of the whole of humanity, the only do we worship, and toward Thee alone we aspire. Open our hearts toward Thy beauty. Illuminate our souls with divine light. O Thou, the perfection of love, harmony, and beauty, all-powerful Creator, Sustainer, Judge, and Forgiver of our shortcomings, Lord God of the East and of the West, of the worlds above and below, and of the seen and unseen beings, pour upon us Thy love and Thy light. Give sustenance to our bodies, hearts, and souls. Use us for the purpose of Thy wisdom chooseth, and guide us on the path of Thine own goodness. Draw us closer to Thee every moment of our life, until in us be reflected Thy grace, Thy glory, Thy wisdom, Thy joy, and Thy peace. Amen. 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 Let us meditate tonight on the prayer of al-Qarib al-Mujib. There are three prayers that go together, actually. The prophets came one after the other, alayhi salatu wassalam. And Sayyidina Hud, Sayyidina Salih, Sayyidina Nuh, telling their people the main message that they have for their people is to remind them of a pair of the divine names. One of them tells his people, Inna Rabbi Rahimun Wadud. The other one says, Inna Rabbi Qaribun Mujib. The other one says, Inna Rabbi Laghafurun Rahim. Inna Rabbi Qaribun Mujib. You know, the common denominator between Nuh, Salih, and Hud, they came for people who were big transgressors. They have transgressed a lot. And one would expect that the normal or the natural thing that one should tell people who are transgressing a lot, Inna Rabbi Azizun Dhu Intiqam. Not Inna Rabbi Rahim Wadud. Not Inna Rabbi Qarib Mujib. One would expect that if you want to talk to people who are transgressors, let us say you are sent now to the people of, to the Israeli army, or to the American army that is supporting the Israeli army. A tyranny, always a tyranny has always manifested in different forms, in different nations, different religions. Let us say you are going to go and talk to them. What are you going to tell them? You have Israeli soldiers in front of you who are killing children, who are bombing houses. They throw to them bags of tahina, farina, flour. They make them fall on their heads to crush them with their heads. Make them run all the way to humiliate them in that way. And at the same time, giving money to the other people to keep killing them. What are you going to tell them? If I tell you, pick a pair of two divine names and go and talk to these people. What is this pair of divine names that we are going to choose? Huh? Please, just let us be honest. Choose two divine names, you know, many of the divine names. Choose two divine names you want to speak to these Israeli soldiers with. Jabbar al-Muntaqim. Here you are. Be careful. Rabbi Jabbar al-Muntaqim. Be careful. Rabbi Aziz al-Intiqam. Be careful. Rabbi Qawi. Aziz. Khudukum akhda Aziz al-Muqtadir. Etc. you are going to think that, natural thing is that I'm going to remind those people about the strength of Allah, about the qahr of Allah, about the power of Allah. These are the two names that you will choose. But that's not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen. That's not what Sayyidina Salih and Sayyidina Hud have chosen. That's not what Sayyidina Salih, Sayyidina Hud, and Sayyidina Nuh have chosen to speak to their people who are even more transgressor, who are transgressing even more. And one should ask himself, why would he tell them, استغفروا ربكم إن ربي قريب مجيب استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه إن ربي رحيم ودود. Ask forgiveness from your Lord and seek His path and ask Him to accept you. My Lord indeed, not إن ربي, my Lord indeed is قريب مجيب, is very close, is very near, and He answers the call. Inna Rabbi, my Lord is very close, is very near, and His Rahim is closer to us than our own selves, and His Wadood, He shows much love. Why? Why? Why would you go to a transgressor, someone who is a tyrant, and you speak to them and you remind them of two divine names like Qarib Mujib? When you hear Qarib Mujib, when you hear these two names, Qarib Mujib, Rabbi Qarib Mujib, my Lord who is taking care of me, the nourisher of my being, the ground of my being, my Rabb, my developer, my increaser, is qareeb, is close, is near, and is mujib, answers the call. Always near, and always here, ready to answer the call. Really, it is a reflection I want to hear from you. I mean, it should. You should ask yourself the question, because it's not a normal thing to come and remind people who are in a position of tyranny, remind them of these two names. Why do you think?
It speaks to the innocence.
It speaks to their?
The innocence.
It speaks to the innocence within them.
It sensitizes
them.
Because if they give a harsh name, they'll say, well, no. They're going to resist. But if you say a name that reminds them of something, where they were once innocent, when they were once...
If he has chosen two names of the Kibriya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those people are mutakabiri, it will be clashing. They will be mu'anideen. It will put them in a position of who cares? We are even bigger. We are even.
They'll see it as a challenge.
They will see it as a challenge. Yeah. He's speaking to the innocence within them, to something that is still soft within them. Because in every human being there is something. That's the thing that you need to talk to. But what else? There is something more. What else?
Maybe the victim will complain to them.
Beautiful. Remind them of, be careful, the victim can... So it's a direct threat. The victim, his Rabb is Qareeb Mujib. Okay. But what else? What makes a person become hard-hearted?
Pain. Distance.
Stubborn.
Distance. Stubbornness. Distance. Sometimes when we when we commit sins, and khalas, the distance becomes so big.
Loss of hope.
We lost hope. We lose hope. Despair. So we need to be reminded of Anna Rabbi Qarib wa Mujib. Had Iblis been able to get these two names, to get the names of Allah al-Qarib, al-Mujib, al-Rahim, al-Wadud, al-Ghafoor, had he been able to get these names, he wouldn't have continued in his transgression. What made him continue in his transgression is that he despaired min rahmatillah. Qanata min rahmatillah. He despaired from the rahmah of Allah. Within each soul, there is that longing. There is that yearning. There is that search. There is that question, at least, within each soul. It's a natural thing, wanting to reconnect to God, wanting to reconnect to the divine. And we want, when we despair, we think it's far from us. The divine is very far from us. It is qareeb, mujib. It's close. It is near. It is here. It answers the call. God is near. God is here. Answers the call. Qareeb and mujib. These names are to the qalb. They reassure the human being, they reassure the qalb of the person. The person who is fearing, the person who is losing hope, the person who is far, but also they soften the heart. They reassure the heart and they soften the heart. Also, my Rabb is not abstract. My Rabb is not an abstract. My Rabb is not somewhere in the sky. My Rabb is near. My Rabb is here. There is an experience that you can get with your Rabb. There is a real life that you can get with your Rabb. There is an experience that you can get with your Rabb. Inna Rabbi Qareeb al-Mujib. It's inviting them to live an experience with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To experience the closeness of Allah. To experience the ijaba of Allah. We find these names again. Not the name, but أجيب دعوة فإني قريب أجيب وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعا. I am close, I am near, and I answer the call. So let us pray with يا قريب يا مجيب إن شاء الله. بسم الله. يا قريب يا مجيب 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 يا al-Qarib ya Mujib, ya Qarib 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 ya Ya Qarib ya Mujib, 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 ya Qarib ya Mujib ya Rabb. Everyone needs a friend, or is looking for a friend that is Qarib and Mujib, that is near, that answers the call. These are the names of the friend. You want a friend that is near, not far, near, Qarib. It's not just the physical distance, it's the emotional distance. Qarib, sahl Qarib. The Prophet says, Al-Mu'min sahl Qarib layyin. Is easy and is close, is Qarib, is layyin, is soft, is Qarib. It's not sahab, ba'id, it's Qarib. And everyone needs a friend who is Mujib, answers the call. When you need, when your need answers the call. Qarib, Mujib. All these contacts that we have on WhatsApp, and really, just, yeah, all of that, what are we looking for? We are looking for Qarib Mujib.
Yeah, yeah.
We are looking for someone who is accessible, who is near, and who answers the call. We are looking for a Qarib Mujib. That's what we are looking for. Mm-hmm. We are looking for Qarib Mujib.
Yeah.
It's an essential need, craving, our souls craving for that. May we find that.
Yeah,
may we find that in our Lord, Yeah, may you find that, may we connect to that, may that need allow us to connect to the Rabb, who is closer to us than our own relatives and who answers the call better than anyone else. Yeah. And may we find that in life, because life is very hard without a Qarib Mujib. Life is very hard when you are lonely. Life is very hard when you are isolated. Life is very hard when you are abandoned. Life is very hard when you don't have people who are near, when you don't have that friend who is near, and when you call, he tells you, I'm here. That's a manifestation that the human being needs. Again, alhamdulillah for these names that make the divine accessible. These are the names of the friend. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. Amen. Give you tawfiq. Just to know.